Students, in this video I will discuss different types of angles, how it comes, how it is related. Suppose AB and CD, these two lines, they intersect at the point O, right? Here angle AOD equal to angle BOC, this is called vertically opposite angle, vertically opposite angle. Same thing, angle AOC equal to angle BOD, vertically opposite angle, right? So if it is X, it is also X. If it is Y, it is also Y. Another one thing, look, on the line AB, DO is inclined. On the line AB, DO is inclined. So angle AOD plus angle BOD can be written as 180 degree because it is sum of two angles of a straight line. This is a straight line, so angle AOB is 180. That is why angle AOD plus angle BOD 180. Or, okay, these are also called adjacent angles. Look, again, here angle AOC plus angle BOC, this is also 180 degrees. Suppose this is the angle ABCD. Here this angle and this angle, these two angles are also adjacent because this is a common side and common point. Both have the common point. This is also adjacent angles. Okay, but it is not 180 degree because it is not a straight line. Yes, sum of these three angles is, suppose A, this is X, this is Y and this is Z. Now it is a straight line, AB, M. It is a straight line, then this one plus this one plus this one equal to 180 degree. So sum of all angles are, but sum of all angles are 80 degree for a straight line. But here the sum of all angles are 360 degree, X plus Y plus Y plus X equal to 360 degree. Why? Because the sum of all angles at a point, particular point, is 360 degree. Here sum of all angles is 360. Here sum of three angles 180 degree. And here sum of two angles is 180. This is also 180 degree. Okay. Now I will come to what is alternate angle, corresponding angle. Okay, this is very important in case of congruency and other things. You should know what is this one. Okay, suppose for alternate angle and for similar for alternate angle and for corresponding angle, what you need at first, you need a pair of parallel straight lines. Pair of parallel straight lines. Look, these are two parallel straight lines, and this is called transversal. These transversal cut the parallel lines in two points P and Q, right? Now this angle and this angle, angle APQ equal to angle PQD, alternate angle. This is called alternate angle. How it is formed? Look, like Z, like this way. This one and this one are alternate angle. Look, this one, alternate angle. Here angle BPQ equal to angle PQC equal to alternate angle. These are all equal, alternate angle. But here angle AMPB equal to angle PQD, these are called corresponding angle. Okay, angle AMPB, this one and this one, angle AMPB equal to angle PQD equal to corresponding angle. Okay, similarly, look, in case of corresponding angle, two angle, one of the angle is outside the parallel and one of the angle is inside the parallel. Between these two parallel lines, one angle is inside, one angle is outside. But in case of alternate angle, we see that both the angles are in the parallel, between the parallel. This thing you should remember. So these are corresponding angles. Okay, it is very easy. Just try to understand and watch the video again and again. Suppose this type of lines are given. These are parallel lines, suppose. So this is the angle formed. So this angle equal to this angle. This is alternate angle. This is alternate angle because this one parallel, this is transversal. Okay. But if we this one, so this angle and this angle are corresponding angle. This angle are corresponding angle. This angle are corresponding angle. Okay. So it is just practice it and watch the video, you will understand. Okay. Now I will give you one sum. Now my question is, look, here A, B and G, C are two lines and EFD is a triangle. Now my question is whether this angle equal to this angle and this angle equal to this angle. Why? Because alternate angle. I will say the answer is no. Why, sir? Because it is not say that is AB and GC parallel. They didn't say that this one parallel. So if AB and GC are not parallel, so this angle are not alternate angle. They are not alternate angle. Yes, if this one parallel, then we can say angle AFE equal to angle FED, alternate angle. Okay. So it is very, very important. Just try to understand what is alternate angle. So for alternate angle, what we need two parallel lines and at least one transversal. This is called transversal, which will cut both the parallel lines. Okay. So if there is no parallel lines, we cannot say there is alternate angle or corresponding angles are formed. So this is very important. Just try to understand what type of angles are given. Before writing anything, you just see whether the all conditions are satisfied or not. Suppose in case of alternate angles, at first you see whether there are two parallel lines or not, whether there is any transversal which will cut both the parallel lines. Both the, look here EF cuts both AB and GC, and FD cuts both AB and GC. Okay, both they are cutting both the angles. So we can say these two lines are parallel. This angle equal. These are called alternate angle. Okay. So these are the concepts of alternate angle, opposite angle and corresponding angle. Hope you enjoy the video and try to make understand, because these are very, very important concept for geometry. Okay. I know everybody knows this. Still, see, there is some confusions. What type of sums are given? Practice some sums from any book and will make you understand. Just watch the video again and again, you will understand. And this type of, before doing any congruency problem or any geometrical problem, you should know what is this type of angles. Without using this, you won't be able to solve the problem. Okay. Thank you, and thank you for watching the video.